Mother. Hi guys, how you doing tonight? I got somebody with me.
Hello.
Hi, Mrs. Mully, how you
Hi.
Doing?
Hi, I'm good.
Well, welcome to the video.
I'm about going to bed.
Yeah.
He stopped me.
It's bedtime. Yes. Anyway, guys, I was on Facebook today, and I saw this on Rocket News 24. Did you see this one?
Yeah, I actually read this article.
Okay, so I kind of wanted to go through these
real quick. I thought that was interesting.
And we'll just kind of keep these, you know, short and quick answers because we only have 12 minutes max on the camera.
Okay,
so anyway, the article from Rocket News 24 is titled Top 10 Things Japanese People Do That Puzzle Us. Mm-hmm. And I kind of wanted to get her opinion on some of these things since she's one of them.
I'm pure.
She's one of them. So anyway.
Genuine Japanese.
Right. Okay, so anyway, the link will be down in the description. Okay, so anyway, all right, number 10.
Yes.
Number 10 was Japanese people are always taking pictures of food.
Yes.
Even airline food, although I've started doing it myself ever since I moved to Japan, blah, blah, blah. Myself, I don't think that is unique to Japan.
I don't think so either.
I think everybody does it.
But this started it, especially after the iPhone become the popular...
We should say smartphones.
Smartphones.
Yeah.
Sorry, smartphone became the popular mobile.
Because you mentioned iPhone and the haters come out. Oh, Android.
Smartphone.
So just say smartphone. Okay, so, okay, now, again, I don't think this is unique to Japan. I think everybody does it. I don't think it's unique enough to say that it's something puzzling that Japanese people do. Okay?
Right.
But the one thing I will say is the Japanese food is usually presented much more beautiful than, and you'll see by the pictures. Okay, are we okay with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Number 9, Japanese people bring souvenir presents to everyone whenever they go out, go to, or come from anywhere.
Yes. That's a custom.
Yes.
Actually.
When Japanese people travel, they usually have to bring gifts for everybody in their like immediate group.
Right.
People at work and everything.
Right.
Now, would you say, for example, in your office, you have a lot of people. So you can't really bring, like, expensive gifts to everybody. Like, you could get, like, a huge bag of candies. Sorry, I cover your face. The little pieces of candy and just leave them on their desk, right? That's fine.
Big boxes of candies or snacks to has enough numbers of the amounts to people can get each one of them.
Right. Okay. All right. And also, a side note to this, is when people visit your home, they always bring something.
But I'm surprised that we have had a lot of visitors from overseas, and everybody brought something for us.
That's right.
So I'm kind of surprised. So maybe that's not just strictly our custom.
Well, I think what it is the, especially the souvenirs, we usually buy souvenirs for like the people we really care about. And like most people at work don't really matter. Okay. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Okay. Number 8. This is from a girl from Singapore. She says in Singapore, it's pretty much summer all year round. So people go out shopping or whatever in t-shirts, shorts, and flip-flops. But in Japan, when she does that, she gets strange looks. So here, even in the heat of summer, you'll see housewives decked out in layers of clothes and makeup, even if they're just out doing grocery shopping.
Yes, sometimes.
Yeah.
For the some wives, the going to grocery shopping is still social activity. So they wanna, they don't want to be looked shabby. And sometimes they want to show some clothes they bought because the neighbors see
neighbors look. Sure.
And especially if you go out, they go out with their friends, they definitely want to show off.
Right. And they're all trying to top each other on what they're wearing. But they never point it out. They never say, look, mine's so much better. They don't do that.
They give in the compliment to each other, but in the head, I'm bitter. Right. mine's more beautiful.
Right. And another thing you'll see is, like, Japanese women are very careful not to get sun on their skin mm-hmm. in the summer.
Yeah.
And you'll see, well, even she does it. She'll cover her arms and her face mm. and everything when she goes out. You'll see women with, like, sleeves on in the summer, and you just look right. at them and you're like, oh my God, it's like 140 degrees out here. How can you be dressed like that? Yeah. Right.
But there's a materials that actually,
yeah,
it's cooler to wear those.
Right. Mm. Okay. Number seven.
Yes.
Scrunchies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, scrunchies, put your hair up, these things.
Shushi. Okay. We call it shush.
Okay. The scrunchie, if you guys don't know, it's a little material fabric scrunchie thing that girls mm. put their hair up with. Mm. Right.
We call it shush.
Okay. Now this one says, scrunchies are seen as kind of childish back home.
Mm.
This is from a British female. Or a relic from the 80s. But in Japan, women wear them all the time, even at work or when they want to dress up.
Yeah. I kind of surprised to read this article because we call shush.
Mm-hmm.
It's a fancy material covered with a rubber band that's mm. hold it tie in your hair, right? Mm. It became a very popular item not too long ago.
Mm.
Before that, we had hair clippers
mm.
and Beretta. Those are
Beretta?
Mm,
hello.
We call Beretta. Beretta, like a pin.
Let me get a cockatoo to sit on my...
Shut up. Those are fancy stuff for hair clips.
Only people my age understand
that. And, yeah, the scrunchies became a popular item.
Mm.
And now it's very standard.
Now, myself, I think they're cute.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe that's because I'm a relic from the 80s.
Mm. Okay.
Could be. Okay, all right, number six.
Mm-hmm.
Japanese people always take their trash back home since there's very few trash cans and they'd never litter. Hold on. I kind of have to take exception to this.
Okay.
If you go to a beach, there's usually a lot of trash laying around.
Mm.
And if you get outside the city, you'll see trash on the sides of the roads and stuff like that. Now, you don't usually see a lot of trash in the cities or in the neighborhoods.
Mm.
But outside, like Tomoko will tell you, we'll be driving down the highway and you'll see 2-liter bottles of piss.
Mm.
Laying on the side of the road, probably some truck driver filled it up and just tossed it out the window.
Especially long distance truck drivers, they don't have time to go to the bathroom. Mm. But I would say, especially after the own terrorism, in the public places we took out all the garbage cans.
Right.
So we are trained. Like taking the garbage to home because no garbage cans on the street.
And for people that don't know that, there was a cult here back in the 90s called the Aum Shinrikyo, and they had did a sarin gas attack in the subways in Tokyo. And since then, after that, they removed the trash cans.
Mm.
Okay, we have 4 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Okay, number five.
Okay.
When Japanese women carry bags, they sometimes do it with their palm out, facing up. So, if you saw someone do that in England, you'd think they were trying to act like a princess or something. It's from a British female. Now, myself, I see nothing wrong with it. And if I think about it, I think you carry your bag like that sometimes.
Right, but we never thought... this is surprising me. This is totally opened my eyes. Mm. I never thought that was because of the trying to be looked princess.
Mm.
It's just the way we hold the box.
Sure.
Because the very short handles, right?
Sure.
There is no way to hold up bags except that way.
I guess if you turn your arm over this way, even if you've got it up, you probably mentally you feel like it's going to slip off.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Anyway, all right. Number four, Japanese women cover their mouths when they laugh.
Yes.
Why?
Because it's manner. You don't show your teeth in public when you laugh.
Okay. And do you know why?
I don't know.
Okay, it started way back. Mm-hmm. I looked this up earlier.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It started way, way back, like in the Nara period. Mm-hmm. Women used to dye their teeth black.
That's right. After you married, you dye the teeth. We dye the teeth the black.
Thanks for adding the married part. I forgot about that. Yeah, they dye their teeth black so they would cover their mouth so nobody could see their teeth.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just kind of stuck. Okay, number three.
Mm-hmm.
Japanese people are very extremely conscious of different ages. So the Kohai Senpai thing.
Mm.
They don't mind just asking you how old you are.
Mm.
Yes.
Yes.
And I've noticed that people that are actually born the same year, if they're in, you know, when you're born in the school year, it changes, right? Mm-hmm. One person, you're born the same year, but one person's a grade ahead of you. Mm-hmm. That's even like, you know, they treat that as...
This is strongly staying in our society.
Very, very strong.
Yeah, still now.
Right. Okay, guys, what I'm going to do is we're going to run out of time here. So I'm going to stop the camera one time and then we'll come back.
Okay.
Okay. All right, we're back. I hope I hope that head jerk was in there. Okay. All right. So, number two.
Okay, two more.
Yeah. Japanese people are pretty frank, which means straightforward, very straight. Yes. When it comes to talking about people's appearance, both good and bad, you have no problem. They have no problem calling someone chubby, even when they've lost weight. Only calling one of two sisters beautiful, etc.
Well, I don't know everything about appearance, but fat or thin, those stuff are very, we don't hesitate to ask, tell other people.
It's not taboo to say somebody, oh, you look like you've put on some weight.
Yeah. Especially when you lose weight, when you lost weight and somebody call you.
Right.
Did you lose weight?
Yeah. You know, you have people walk up to, if you were back in the States and somebody says, hey, you look like you put on some weight, you'd be like, mother. I'll beep that out. You'd be like, why did you say that to me? But here, it's just, it's standard. And if you're overweight and you come to Japan, be prepared for that. People will talk about your weight. They'll touch you. Try not to be offended by it because they're not trying to be cruel.
No, not at all.
No.
That's just our custom.
It's just the way
just
it
the
is.
The way we are.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. And the number one, number one thing is, Japanese people don't accept any praise for anything, no matter what.
Yes.
Oh, no, I'm not smart at all. I'm really stupid.
Yeah.
And I'm not cute either.
Yeah. This is probably very difficult to explain, to explain in the right way to people understand. But we're as a human, we're told being
modest
or egotistical.
Being egotistical
is not beauty,
right?
As a human,
okay,
morality,
okay.
So hesitation, or I don't know the word, being overconfidence is not very beauty.
Okay. So modesty is best.
Not taking the wrong way.
No. That's fine. You know, actually, you know, I think that's not that's not unique to Japan.
Yeah.
I think, you know, even like when I was a kid, we were taught, don't talk yourself, you know, keep your ego in check, right? But now everybody's so special, you know. No, not everybody's special. Okay. So I've noticed that, like, you can compliment somebody. You can tell a mother, like her teenage son or something, or their daughter. Like, there's something else, a son or a daughter.
Sorry, I just ran through.
Or their house or their car or whatever. We'll keep it with the son and daughter. You could say, "Oh, your son is doing so great in school. He's such a good-looking kid." Blah blah blah. And they're like, "No. He's stupid. He's dumb. He's right."
Well, we don't purposely say bad things when somebody give you a compliment, but I will not. How can I say it? Somebody tell me, you're so beautiful, your hair is so nice, right? Something like that. So when people tell me that, I try not to be stuck up with myself.
Okay, do you say thanks?
Yeah, of course. Of course, we say thanks, but...
thanks, but there's so many split ends.
Yeah.
Always have to put a little dig into it, right?
Yeah, because... If I just take the compliments that yes I am, yes my hair is, that attitude given other people, oh, she's so stuck up.
Okay, there you go.
I don't know. I'm sorry. I wish I could explain better way, but
no, you're perfectly fine. So everybody, give her a thumbs up for her English. She does really well.
And all these 10 things, I agree. I agree every single one of them, but it's not everybody's. There's of course some people not like this all the time.
Right.
But we tend to be like this.
Right. Yeah. But go back to the original statement.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think any of these are really puzzling. You know, why do Japanese people do that? Mm-hmm. You know, maybe the covering the mouth, you know, that's not something that we do back in the United States. But I've read somewhere, I think it was some of the comments on this article, you know, women covering their mouths is a sign of good etiquette in a lot of countries.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, well, you know, I don't know.
Mm. Yeah, and then again, if you go to a different country you've never been to.
Right.
You probably have some surprises, too.
Yeah, so, there you go.
Yeah.
There's always going to be culture shock.
Right.
Okay. All right, guys. Well, that is it. It is, it's 1:50. It's 12:51. It's almost 1 o'clock in the morning, and she's got to be up at 5:30?
Yes. 5.
5? Okay. All right. So, she's going to go to bed. I'm going to put this video together and put it up for you guys. And, I guess.
I have to go to work tomorrow.
Okay. Now, make sure you do the sign off. Okay.
Okay.
Now, oh, wait a minute. I want to move my head here. If you guys look behind me, don't forget the Big Paul t-shirts.
Yes.
There's like 8 days left.
There.
And we've only sold 10. We need to sell 20 more. Yes. So, if you guys can help, I'd really, really appreciate
it's
a
really
it.
Cool shirt.
I want to hit that goal of 30. So the people that have ordered get their shirts, and all the cool kids have one. So you can go to www.teespring.com/bigpaws-bignuts.
And make sure to...
The hyphen.
Yeah.
Hyphen. Bigpaws-bignuts. And I'll put the link down below for you can click on right over there. $20, you know, it's for a good shirt. And they're good Hanes t-shirts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Good quality t-shirts and cool design.
Right. Okay. All right, guys. Well, we're going to leave you with that. Tomoko's going to give you the meatloaf. And
thank you guys for watching us. And
no, wait. So that's it. We'll see you guys later. And
don't let your meatloaf.